Hello and welcome to the Montage Film Review Sunday DVD Rental Suggestion Podcast at the beginning of a month dedicated to the actress Marilyn Monroe. Marilyn Monroe's tragic life is pretty much well documented, from her broken childhood to her time spent on the casting couch, to her marriages, affairs and attempts to have children, ending in her untimely death. I am not going to concentrate on the conspiracy theory surrounding the greatest sex symbol of the 20th century. I am going to focus on the reality of her world and movies in what was a short career. To start us off on this journey, I have chosen Don't Bother to Knock, from 1952 and directed by Roy Baker. Prior to this, Marilyn had bit parts in 15 films, with The Asphalt Jungle and All About Eve being my favourites of the bunch, which I think she made them back to back in 1950. All About Eve, as you should know, stars the marvellous Betty Davis and is a critique of the dubious methods that some actresses take to get to the top. And Asphalt Jungle is an excellent film noir about a bank heist. After Don't Bother to Knock, she would make another two films before embarking on the production of her most famous efforts during what would be the peak of her career. It annoys me to hear people talk of Marilyn as a victim and a lost child, because I don't believe that she was either. She was a very beautiful woman with a lot of ambition who went the wrong way about getting the things that she wanted. Her childhood's lack of protection and nurturing was to blame for this, but who is to say that if she had had a real family, they would have been the type to have taught her any different. You have only got to listen to an interview with this actress to understand that she believed that using her body was the way to get what she wanted, and that this was something that she had learned very early on whilst in foster care, when she was still a child and all the neighbourhood boys hung around outside her house and let her ride their bikes, which she used to do with relish, one after the other. When Marilyn Monroe was still married to her first husband, who was away at sea, she used to hang around in cafes to kill time. And about it, she said, "Those bars were full of agents, or at least guys who claimed they were. A lot of the girls who hung around there hoped they would break into movies that way. This agent really liked me. I think we met a few times. He told me that I was special and that I had the look to be in movies. He said that if I did this, what I was doing with the right men, I might be able to make it in pictures. I laughed at him and told him that I couldn't act. And he said, neither can so-and-so or so-and-so. He named some of the biggest actresses then. I thought about it after he left. You know, I decided maybe he was right. At first it was just a thought, but it got bigger and bigger. It became my ambition, my only ambition, the first one I ever had. Everybody in Hollywood was there to check over the new girls. We had our choice. We could be picked up by some handsome young actor and have a little fun, or we could go off with some old bigwig and make a few dollars." At the beginning of her career, she associated with the wrong types and continued to do so way into her career, so that at the point when she decided that she wanted to educate herself and be taken seriously, she was completely mocked for it. In this film, she plays Nell, a mentally disturbed girl who is helped into work by her uncle. He comes up with the idea of her minding the children of the patrons of the hotel that he works in. But on her first night, she runs into trouble. When Bunny, the child, goes to sleep, Nell tries on her mother's clothes, and then she catches the eye of Jed, played by Richard Widmark, the man across the way who has just been dumped by his girlfriend, Lynn, played by Anne Bancroft, and is keen to forget her in the arms of another woman. She has pulled the brakes on the relationship, which began as casual in the hotel bar where she works. She is also concerned about his lack of feelings towards others, but this is corrected when he is forced to contend with Nell's relapse into melancholy and violence when she mistakes him for her dead boyfriend. Don't Bother to Knock is set in New York and based on a novel by Charlotte Armstrong. As always, you have been listening to the Montage Film Review Sunday DVD Rental Suggestion Podcast, an Eskimo Fin production. The quote used earlier in this edition is taken from the book Marilyn Monroe in Her Own Words, published by Omnibus Press.